you are applying for a CCA under AIPP program, do I need an NNAS? So these are the common questions that we received this past few weeks. Cap, do I really need to have an NNAS? Because I'm trying to apply for CCA. So in this video, I'm going to answer this question. But before we start, I would like to invite you to join our Pinoy Canada Immigration Forum. So if you're looking for support or if you want to ask questions, please join our forum because we have lots of community that are willing to help you because sharing is caring. But anyway, another one is follow me on my social media. It's When in Halifax. Follow me on my Facebook and Instagram. And then, of course, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. So let's begin. So if you are a registered nurse and maybe one of your dream is to come here in Canada with yourself or with your family, and AIPP is one way that you see as one way of the easiest way to migrate here in Canada. So maybe you're asking and wondering, do I really need to have an NNAS? So the answer is no. If we're talking about AIPP program, if we're talking about Atlantic Immigration Pilot Program, you don't need to have an NNAS. Okay, so it's very clear. If you are applying for AIPP program, even you're a nurse or you're not, NNAS is not part of the requirements. It's not part to be eligible. It's not required to be eligible for AIPP. NNAS is not required. So it's very clear, mga kap. Again, NNAS is not requirement for AIPP. However, okay, if you want to have an edge, you want to have advantage to other competitor or other applicant, as a CCA, it is advantage to have an NNAS. What's the reason? Because when we applied here, when we came here, we are international educated nurses or RN in the Philippines. So when we came here, we applied for CCA instead of RN because we don't have a license yet. Based from our experience, when we applied for CCA position, three of the companies that I applied, they never asked me a diploma, training, BLS, certification, transit. They never asked me those documents. There's only one document they ask. What's that? That's the NNAS. There's only one question they ask me. Are you a registered nurse and planning to upgrade your profession or being a nurse? And I say, yes. Do you have an NNAS? So I just give them a copy of my NNAS application. To make it short, hi. So this is one way to show to the employer that you have a legit experience. You have a legit registration. You have a legit education through the NNAS. Again, let's go back to AIPP. Since AIPP is employer driven, it means that the employer has a decision which and who we're going to hire or who we're going to get a position. The employer only has the power. The employer have the power to choose kung sino yung gusto nilang kunin, right? So if you are the employer, you want an applicant that is nurse, applicant with experience. The question now is, how can the employer verify that you are a registered nurse? How can the employer verify that you have a valid experience? And the only way the employer can verify those things are through the NNAS. So for me, in my own perspective, it's not written online. For my perspective, if I am an employer, if I am the nursing home, if I am the facility, to verify your experience, to verify your education, I can only verify those information through the NNAS. So again, if you want to have an edge, if you want to have an advantage, then take the NAS. But if you're asking me, sir, cap, do I really need to have an NNAS for my AIPP application? The answer is no. If you're asking, cap, what are my strategy so that I can find an employer? Because I feel frustrated and I don't know to go. I don't know what to do. Again, if you're a registered nurse, maybe if you have a budget, if the money is not an issue, then take the NNAS. The NNAS is a little bit expensive. You are looking around $600 US dollars for one application. So try to weigh everything. But for me, if you're really sure that you want to be here in Canada, I think NNAS is, try to get the NNAS, because anyway, you will take the NNAS if you are here in Canada. So again, if you're very sure that you will migrate in here in Canada, I think it's not a waste if you're going to take the NNAS. But if you're not sure, you are 50-50 of not migrating in Canada or not, I will not recommend to take the NNAS, because the NNAS cannot help you with your immigration. The purpose of the NNAS for your nursing registration. Even though you have an NNAS, then it cannot help your CRS score. It cannot help you with your application here in Nova Scotia or even with your express entry. The NNAS, the purpose of the NNAS is for nursing registration. It only gives you an advantage when you are applying under AIPP so that the employer can say, okay, this applicant is really a nurse because you already have NNAS application. Because the NNAS application is the only way to verify your profession. So that's it, guys. I hope you're able to find the answer where you're looking for, and I hope I'm able to help you. If you find it very informative, please don't forget to like this video, share this video to your friends and loved ones, and of course, join our forum. It's Pinoy Canada Immigration Forum. By the way, mga kap, if you have more questions, if you have lots of questions in mind, I highly encourage you to join our every Saturday, Manila time, 12 noon Manila time Saturday, we have a Q&A question with our friend, Miss Amelia Ajok of Ajok International. So Miss Amelia Ajok is an immigration consultant. So if you have questions of anything about immigration, Canada immigration, join us. Join us on Saturday, 12 noon, in our Facebook and YouTube channel. If you are here in Canada, it's Halifax time, 12 midnight. Thank you, Bob. See ya. Bye-bye.